Here's something you don't usually associate with a symphony orchestra. But then again, why not? Because classical composers in Mexico and Brazil and Cuba and Argentina do what composers do everywhere. They use their local musical traditions and weave them right into the orchestra. And as you'll hear today, they wind up with some pretty hot stuff. Now, he included some of his own music in this concert. The musical West Side Story had been a huge hit 5 years before, and had just been made into a movie, and everyone knew it. It's still one of the most famous musicals ever. And he was signing his contract to be the musical director of the New York Philharmonic while the show was in final rehearsals. He was leaving Broadway for the symphony world, but not altogether. Just as he had taken that Latin American spirit and made it into a musical about Puerto Ricans and gang rivalry in New York, he brought Broadway to the Philharmonic when he wrote this symphonic arrangement, a piece that shows up regularly on symphony programs today. He was always torn among his many musical passions. When he was conducting, he wanted to be composing. When he was writing musicals, he thought he should be writing symphonies. Yet somehow, he managed to do something brilliant with all of them.
Now, the second element that we find so attractive in Latin American music is all that special instrumental color. It's unmistakable. You're never in doubt about what kind of music you're listening to the moment you hear, for instance, this colorful little sound. Now, that's a pair of maracas. And what's a rumba or a samba without a pair of maracas? The same is true of that well-known dry little sound you get from hitting two sticks together, what the Cubans call claves. And then there are all kinds of gourds like this. And rasping sticks. And an endless variety of other things like conga drums and bongos that make the music sound Latin. Now, actually, I'm not crazy about that word Latin to describe this kind of music because it tells only part of the story. When we speak of Latin America, we are, of course, referring to the historical fact that these countries were conquered, settled, and exploited by invaders from Latin countries like Spain, or as in the case of Brazil, from Portugal. And that's why Spanish and Portuguese are still the official languages of our friends to the south of us. And those languages are called Latin languages because they developed from the old language of ancient Rome. But the Latin American spirit, which is our subject today, has other ancestors besides the Latin ones, at least as important. And they are, first of all, the Indians, the original inhabitants of those countries, and in some cases, very strong civilizations in themselves. And secondly, Africans, a tremendously important influence, at least as important as it is in our own country. And it's the mingling of these different ancestors, influences, and heritages which makes the Latin American spirit what it is, at any rate, in music. But we mustn't begin to think that all Latin American music is only chaka-chaka-chaka-chaka dance music, not by a long shot. Our Latin neighbors have produced a very impressive number of serious symphonic composers who have succeeded in preserving the folk flavor of their own countries while at the same time expanding their music into what we think of as universal art. That is, music that has not only a nationalistic spirit, but the spirit of all mankind.